cannot synthesize their own food.
What will fill here?
Heterotrophs.
Heterotrophs, right. They do not make food of themselves. Then next question. The does a plant absorb water and mineral from the soil?
Roots.
Roots. During photosynthesis, this is the only chapter that is coming, right?
There is one more chapter, motion and time.
Okay, we'll do motion first because this chapter we already did in earlier, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. Motion also we did it earlier?
Yes.
Okay, no problem. So let's start here. An object is said to be at rest if it
does not change its position with time.
Right. SI unit of time is?
Meter per second.
No, time. How you measure time?
Time is distance upon speed. Yeah, it's second.
SI unit of time is second.
Time is second. Yes.
Yeah, it is meter per second is the unit of speed.
Speed.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
The child sitting in a revolving giant wheel is an example of
dash motion. Revolving giant means circular motion.
Circular motion, right. A car moving on a busy straight road is an example of dash motion.
Non-uniform rectilinear motion.
Busy straight road.
Yeah, busy. If that means it's not moving in equal distance, right? In equal intervals of time. So that
non-uniform
is non-uniform
motion, you can say.
Yes.
Yeah. Speedometer of a motorbike measure is speed in.
Speedometer. Kilometer per hour.
Kilometer per hour. Okay.
Yes.
The speed of fast moving train is usually measured in meter per hour. True or false?
False.
The average speed remains constant for an object having a uniform motion.
True.
Average speed. Yeah, it's true.
True.
A man walks for 1 meter at a speed of 1 meter per second along a straight track. The total distance covered by him is 1 meter. True or false?
False.
How much distance covered?
60 meters.
60 meters. An object moving along a straight line is said to be a uniform motion if it covers regularly increasing distance in equal interval of time. True or false?
Regularly increasing distances means 10, 20, 30 or means like
regularly
you can say
increasing distances. Means first distance is 10, then 20, then 30. That is your regularly increasing distance.
Then it's true.
Cover regularly increasing distance. Regular increasing, so it is true. Regular means in first hour it covers 10, then second, then 20, then 30. Okay, so it starts from here, then it goes to 10 kilometer, then 20 kilometer, then 30 kilometer, then 40 kilometer. So it will be all is going in same interval of
uniform.
Time, so it will be uniform. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. time period of simple pendulum takes 42 seconds to complete 20 oscillation equal to 2.1 second. True or false?
True.
True. Because yes. You need to divide 42 divided by 20, right?
20. Yes.
It comes 2.1. Okay, next question. A distance time graph for a car kept park on the side road is a straight line parallel to time axis. True or false?
True, because it's not showing any movement.
Earlier we discussed, this is your distance and this is your time. Yeah. Sorry. Okay, so distance is constant. This is the graph, right?
Yes.
Yeah. All type of graph we discussed earlier, right?
Yes.
Next question. Read it.
Out of the following, the only correct formula is the second one, distance is equal to speed into time.
Right. Then next, second number.
A man walks on a straight road from his home to a market 3 kilometers away with a speed of 6 kilometers per hour. The time taken by man to go from his home to market equals 30 minutes.
Right. Okay. Third question.
The odometer of a car reads 57,321.0 kilometers when the clock shows the time as 8:30 a.m. The odometer reading changes to 57,336.0 kilometers at time 8:50 a.m. The distance moved by the car in these 20 minutes equals 15 kilometers.
336 minus 321.
Yes, 15,
right?
Yes.
So this will be the answer. Fourth,
following distance graphs, the graph that represent a truck at rest is a graph labeled truck at rest. That is the first one.
Out of the following distance time graph, the graph that represented truck is at rest. So which one is the correct answer?
First one.
Right. Can you tell me what this graph means? Second graph means?
This graph means that the truck is in motion.
Uniform motion.
Yeah, uniform motion.
Yeah, C graph does not exist because without changing time, distance increasing. It cannot happen, right?
Yeah.
And this graph, truck at it some distance from us and gradually as time increase is coming towards us, okay?
Yes.
Yeah. Next, fifth question. Read it.
In the given diagram of a simple pendulum, the time taken by the bob to move from X to Z is T1 and from Z to O is T2. The time period of this simple pendulum is 2 multiplied by T1 plus T2.
Yeah. Because x to z it is t1, right?
Yes.
And from z to o it is t2.
T2.
Okay. So from here to here it is t1 plus t2. And then again here to here it is t1 plus t2. Then again here to here t1 plus t2. Then again here to here t1 plus t2. So time period will be 4 times t1 plus t2, right?
Because one oscillation will be four
times. One oscillation means a body from here it goes to there, then come back here, then again goes there and again come back here. So this is one full oscillation.
Oscillation. And okay, if you just want to check when you can say just one half oscillation, then two multiplied by two.
Right.
Or else if you want to see full oscillation, then multiplied by four.
Right. SI unit of speed will be?
Meter per second.
Right. Question number D, A, 1. Can you read it and solve it?
A boy walks to his school with a constant speed of 4 km per hour and reaches there in 30 minutes. Find the distance of the school from his house. Yeah. 4 km per hour and in 13 minutes.
Yeah.
That is...
4 km is a... Find the distance of the school. So 4
2 km.
Multiplied by half hour, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. That is 2. Second question.
The distance between two stations is 216 km. A bus takes 4 hours to cover this distance. Calculate the average speed of the bus in kilometer per hour. Yeah. So then we need to divide 216 upon 4. That will give us 54 kilometer per hour.
Right. Next, third.
Cars A and B are moving with average speeds of 40 km per hour and 50 km per hour respectively in the same direction. Find how far will car B be from car A after 3 hours.
Right. So how will you do that?
So first we will multiply the 40 km per hour into 3 hours. That will give us 120 kilometer.
Right.
And 50 into 3 will give us 150 kilometer. So
right,
when we subtract 150 from 120, we will get 30 kilometer. So car B will be 30 kilometer far from car A.
Right. Question number 4.
A car moves with a speed of 40 km per hour for 15 minutes and then with a speed of 60 km per hour for the next 15 minutes. Find the total distance covered by the car in these 30 minutes.
Right.
So the first, the car's speed is 40 km per hour in 15 minutes. So we will divide it.
Divide to find distance, we multiply, right?
Yeah, to find distance, we multiply. Sorry, divide as it. Speed into time, we will multiply so that we give the answer. So, first we will find 60 plus 40, that will be 100. See,
40 kilometer per hour for 15 minutes. It
yes.
means 40 multiplied by 15 minutes means 1 by 4 hours, right? That give you 10 kilometers.
Okay.
Okay. Then 60 kilometers per hour for next 15 minutes. So that is 60 multiplied by 15 means 1/4 hour. Okay.
Okay.
That is 15 kilometer. So total distance will be 10 plus 15. That is 25 kilometer.
Okay.
Understood? And don't forget to convert minute into hours.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, next question.
Then define the term periodic motion. Give two examples of periodic motions that can be used to measure time.
Right. So the motion which repeats itself by a certain interval of time is called periodic motion, right?
Periodic motion. Yes. Example, the sunrise and sunset.
Sunrise, sunset, okay.
Time. Yeah, because the sun helps to cast shadow in the sundial to measure time.
Right.
Then the periodic motion.
The pendulum of a clock is the best example. Okay.
Okay.
And the second example, you can give the swing. The swing in the park, it repeats its motion continuously, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. Distinguish between uniform and non-uniform motion.
Uniform motion. The motion which takes, which covers equal distance in equal intervals of time is called uniform motion. And the motion which covers non-equal distance in equal unequal distance, you can say.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that is also non-uniform motion.
Yeah. Okay. Good, good. Then seventh. Draw the shape of distance-time graph for a man waiting for bus, standing at one point on bus stand. So its graph will
It will be parallel to time, right?
Right.
So showing distance, this is time.
This is your distance, this is time. So distance is not changing. So it will be a straight line like this. Next.
A man walking on a level, straight and narrow road with a constant speed. So that will be means the distance in time. And
so initially at this distance, as time increases, its distance increases. Means it will go like this. Okay?
Yes. Yes. Yeah. In constant motion.
Right. Next question.
A farmer moves along the boundary of a rectangular field ABCD as shown in the figure. He takes 4 minutes to travel across each side. 4 minutes to each side.
Yeah.
So if he is traveling from, is the motion of this farmer uniform or non-uniform? Mm-hmm. Find his average speed over one complete round of the field. So this farmer is going non-uniform motion.
Why non-uniform?
Because while he is covering A to B, he is covering 4 minutes, which is equal to 80 meter. And he is in another 4 minutes, that is from B to C, he is covering 40 meter. So he is not covering equal distance in equal intervals of time. So that's why it is non-uniform.
Right. Next. Second.
Now find, there is one more question. Find his average speed over one complete round.
Find the average speed. So total distance, how much total distance is traveling?
Then he's 240 meter in 16 minutes.
Yeah, so what is the speed?
So 240 upon 16.
But convert it into second, because you need to make it meter per second, right? So it will be 240.
Yes, so then
divide by 16, 16 into 60, 960. Right?
Yes, 960.
So 1/4 so meter per second.
We will
second.
Cut the zero, then 24 and 96. Yes, 1/4.
Yeah. During rainy season, Shivam noted that the thundering speed of cloud was heard 6 seconds after the lightning was seen by him. If the speed of sound is 340 meter per second, find the distance of point where thundering sound was produced. How will we do? You do.
So 6 seconds after the lightning was seen by him. So right. 340 meter, find the distance. So yeah. To find the distance, we will multiply speed into time. So 340 into 6.
Right. You can multiply it, but write properly, yes. Okay?
Yes.
Next, third.
How can we make a simple pendulum? We can make a simple pendulum by taking a small bob, which you can say, tie it with a rope.
Right.
And let it swing. It will automatically go in a periodic motion, which will complete when and after completing one oscillation, you will see the pen. Just going like, you know, a pendulum.
Right. And next question, 3B.
A simple pendulum takes 10 seconds to complete 5 oscillations. Find the time period of this pendulum. So time is equal to distance upon speed.
Yeah.
Now
10 seconds to complete 5 oscillations. It means 10/5, right?
Yeah, 10/5. So that will be 2 seconds per oscillation.
Right. Fourth.
Carefully examine the data given below for motion of two different objects A and B. State whether the motion of these two objects is uniform or non-uniform.
Yeah.
So, for the total distance covered by A, it's going in uniform motion. And the distance covered by B is going on non-uniform motion.
Okay. So what distance is uniform or non-uniform?
The A1 is uniform and the B1 is non-uniform.
A is uniform. Because 7 to 7:30, 20, then 7:30 to 7:45, okay, right?
After every 15 minutes, it's going on in
10
a
kilometer.
10 kilometer distance. So it's uniform. And B is going in a non-uniform motion.
Right. Next. 5.
Observe the graph given here. From the graph, find the values of distances P and Q in M and the value of time R in seconds.
Yeah. So P will be like time is 4. So time is 4.
Yeah.
So for so that distance is 3. Right?
3 meter.
Yeah.
Yes.
This goes and this goes. Okay.
Yes.
And then if distance is 9, so take a straight line parallel to x axis, then go down. So time will be 12. So R is 12. Q, if the time is 16.
It's also 12. It's also 12.
Okay.
Yeah, it's only that much.
Okay. Okay, we'll do the first chapter then. I hope you will do good in next tomorrow exam.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so second we did it. Third. During photosynthesis,
plants take in dash and release dash. Plants take in carbon dioxide and release oxygen.
Okay.
Dash are the tiny pores through which leaves exchange gases.
Right.
Stomata are the tiny pores.
Yeah.
Fifth. Insect-eating plants are called dash plants. Insectivorous plants.
Insectivorous. Sixth.
An essential raw material needed for the process of photosynthesis and available in the soil is water and minerals, and available in the air is carbon dioxide.
Right. Next.
For match the following, the chlorophyll will go to leaf.
Okay.
Lichen will go to symbiotic relationship. Fungi will go to saprotrophs. Amoeba will go to parasite, and plants will go to autotrophs.
Okay.
Yes.
C.
Green plants that can synthesize their own food are known as autotrophs.
Right.
The food factory of the plant is its leaf.
Leaf.
Which of the following is insectivorous plants? Pitcher plant.
Pitcher plant. Mushroom is an example of?
Saprotroph.
An organism that fixes nitrogen in soil is?
Rhizobium.
Rhizobium, right. D.
Why is nutrition important for a living organism?
Yeah.
Nutrition is important for living organism because actually nutrition, we get nutrition from nutrients, and nutrients help us to grow, to repair the damaged parts, and give energy to carry out life processes. So if we will not get nutrition, we cannot perform the tasks. So that's why nutrition is important for a living organism.
Right. How do green plants synthesize their food?
Green plants synthesize their food with the help of sunlight. A green pigment
in the presence of sunlight. Yeah.
Yeah, in the presence of sunlight. The green pigment called chlorophyll captures the energy of sun. And which helps it to synthesize their food in the presence of carbon dioxide and water.
Okay.
State the role of vessels present in the plant. Okay, yeah. The role of vessels is to transport water and minerals to different parts of plant.
Right. What these vessels are called?
Vessels are called small tubes.
Small tubes.
Help the plant to transport water and minerals.
Small tubes are called vessels.
Yes. Define the following term, symbiotic relationship. Okay.
Right.
When two organisms live in a close association and develop a relationship between two which is beneficial to both, is called symbiotic relationship. Example, lichens. Lichen is a living partnership of fungi and alga. Fungi helps alga. Means fungi gives shelter to water to alga, whereas alga prepares food for fungi. So it's both beneficial for them.
Okay. Next,
nutrients. It is say nutrients are present in food. Nutrients are they enable living or that there are different types of nutrients, that is carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. They all are important components of nutrients. These components of food are necessary for our body and are called nutrients.
Is a substance that provide nourishment essential for the maintenance of life and for growth. Got it?
Yes.
Or you can say nutrients are compound in food essential for life and health. Repeat it.
Yes.
Repeat it.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, just repeat the definition of nutrients.
Sir, your voice is not coming.
Hello. Now it is okay?
Yeah, now it's coming. Yeah, now.
Okay. So nutrients are compound in food essential to life and health.
Nutrients are food?
Nutrients. My voice is not coming.
It's coming now.
Nutrients are compounds in foods essential to life and health.
Okay. Nutrients are compounds in food?
Essential for life and health, you can
life
say.
And health.
Yeah. Or here also you did something, na? Why nutrients important for living organism? What did you say for that?
That I said that nutrients enable us to grow, to repair damaged parts, and to give energy. They give energy to carry out life processes.
Right. The same way you can define this also, like nutrients are the compound in food which give us energy and by which we grow, and you can whatever you said you can write it. Okay.
Yes.
Sapotrophic
mode of nutrition. Okay. Yeah. This is the mode of nutrition in which plants derive their food from dead and decaying organic matter. For example, mushroom, fungi, mucor, etc.
Okay. Just a second. Photosynthesis.
Okay. The process by which plants make their own food is called photosynthesis.
Right. You can say like that, the process by which a plant make their food in presence of sunlight. Okay?
Yes. Yes. When some wheat dough was left in open for a few days, it started emitting a foul smell. State why? Okay. Yeah. Now wheat dough, when it is left outside for a few days, it will contain fungi or few bacteria that will make it which we cannot eat. that it will make
it generate turn. Fungi which is not good for health.
Yeah.
Or you can say the fungi. You can just say it generate fungi in the presence of water and dust. That is why it start a smell, because of presence of fungi. Okay.
Yes.
That much you can write. Just the presence of fungi make it smell.
Yes.
Okay. Next question number first. E first.
Why would life not be possible on the earth in the absence of photosynthesis?
Right.
Now, photosynthesis is the process which is done in the presence of sunlight. So, if photosynthesis, plants will not do photosynthesis, we will not get oxygen. Right. And which
see,
is a
you can say that for life, we need food, and food only can be made in the presence by photosynthesis only. So that is why, or this way you can write.
You can also say that if plants will not do photosynthesis, they will not give us oxygen. And if we will not
breathe oxygen. This is also right. But in this chapter, like you say, on the basis of food.
It said that photosynthesis is a food that is made in plants.
Yeah. Okay. Next.
Give reasons for the following. Mushroom is a saprotroph. Yes, because mushrooms feed on dead and decaying organic matter. Yeah. That's why they are known as saprotrophs.
Yeah.
Sun is the ultimate source of energy for all living organisms. Yes, it is beneficial for both plants and animals. As in plants, they need it in the process of photosynthesis. And then we need it to grow ourselves, because it gives us vitamins, which is a nutrition.
Yeah.
So sun is the ultimate source of energy for all living organisms.
Because through sun only a plant makes food, and that is why we get, that is how we get food from the plant, right? This way you can write.
Yes.
Yeah. Next.
The leaf of plant dies out if its stomatas are blocked. Okay. Stomatas are the tiny pores which help the leaves in exchange of gases. So if plants, if stomatas are blocked, plant cannot exchange the gas. So they cannot take carbon dioxide or cannot give oxygen. So they would die automatically.
Yeah. Stomata are blocked. Because if a stomata will block, they cannot, they will not able to take carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, right?
Okay, yes.
Leaf is known as food factory of the plant.
Yeah, because leaf are known as food factory of plant, because leaf it make food for the whole plant. Taking carbon dioxide from air, sunlight through chlorophyll,
right,
and water through roots and vessels. So they all reach to the leaf and make and do the process of photosynthesis.
Right. Or you can say that food made at the plant leaf only. That is why it is called food factory of the plant. That way, first understand why it is called factories. Factory, it is called factory because?
Because the factory is, you can say it provides to all.
Yeah.
Means whatever thing you prepare in factory, you can prepare in a large amount, which you can give to the whole you know, the
you can say just food factory, because all the food is being prepared there. That is why we call as food factory of the plant. Yes. That yes. way you can say. Yes. E. Yes.
Lichen is a living partnership between a fungus and an alga, and this partnership is beneficial to both. Okay. So this is called symbiotic relationship.
Right.
In this living relationship, what happens is fungus absorb waters and transport it to alga. And fungus also provides shelter to alga. Whereas alga prepares food for fungus, so this partnership is beneficial to both.
Right. Why do some plant feed insects? How does pitcher plant catches insects? Have you seen pitcher plant?
Some plants, yeah, I have seen pitcher plant.
Last class I show you a video, right?
Yeah, that was Venus flytrap.
Yeah, okay.
And pitcher plant as well.
So actually when the insects sit on it, it get close and insect trap inside it, right?
Yeah, actually they need insects, they need to feed on insects because the soil does not contain that much nutrients they need.
Yeah.
So that's why they need to feed on insects to get nutrition.
Right.
Yeah, and pitcher plant has a lid. The leaf works the lid. It helps in opening and closing the mouth. So when and fly enters it, it will fall as it is a down pointing of the whole plant is a down pointing hairs they have. So when it will try to climb out, the hair will push it down and the lid will close. So the pitcher fly, the insect will go and it will be digested by the digestive juices present there.
Yeah, you can just, you understand the mechanism, so write in your language, that is the best way.
Yes.
Next is, how do rhizobium bacteria and leguminous plant help each other in their survival?
Rhizobium helps the to convert nitrogen into its usable form.
Okay.
And leguminous plants give shelter to rhizobium and also food. So this they then
yeah you can say
they help each other in their survival.
They help each other, but how they help? Like they convert into usable nitrogen.
Yeah, rhizobium convert nitrogen into usable form, so that is used by leguminous plants for their nutrition. And when rhizobium bacteria also lives in roots, root nodules, so that's why leguminous plants provide them shelter in roots, and also means it provides shelter and rhizobium provides nitrogen. So that's why they help them both in their survival.
Okay. Complete the wave chart.
Sunlight, carbon dioxide from air, okay, absorbed by roots. Water and minerals absorbed by roots. And one thing left is chlorophyll, which is already present in leaf. So the resulting formation of oxygen and carbohydrates, which is also known as glucose.
So here it will be plant, sunlight, carbon dioxide, water, right?
Yeah.
And plant, then?
Sunlight, carbon dioxide, water, and chlorophyll.
Chlorophyll.
Yes.
Okay. carbon dioxide from air, water from roots, chlorophyll in leaf, right?
Present in present in leaf.
Okay. And so
and it will result in formation of oxygen and carbohydrates that is also known as glucose.
Yeah. Oxygen and carbohydrate, right?
Yeah, you can simply write glucose.
Yeah, glucose, right? You can say glucose. Okay, next question. It is a crossword actually.
Yes.
So first we fill last time, it was parasite, right? A plant parasite. Which parasite plant it is?
Cascuta.
Okay. So it will go across. Can you fill it and send me on the WhatsApp?
Okay, I'll do it.
Yeah, just fill it and send me on the WhatsApp. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, that's all.
Yes.
Anything else you want to clear?
No, I understood all thing you told.
Yeah, this biology part, just try to do more about yourself. As far as I know, I taught you, but try to do yourself and try to understand the things and write in your language. That will be better.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
But for motion part, you can do good. Because we already revised, this is the second time we are revising, doing it. So, not a problem. Okay?
Yes.
Okay. If anything else, you just call me or you can text me and fill this crossword and send me, okay?
Yes. Now only I will do it.
Okay. Okay. Bye.